The highest elevations in our southern Appalachian Mountains are very unique. They support some species of plants and animals that occur nowhere else on Earth, only in North Carolina at the high elevations. There's a very long winter, a very short growing season, and there is a huge amount of rainfall and precipitation in these areas.
Most of the environments here have thin soils. They're very acidic. Here at Grandfather Mountain, we're known for our winds. We're one of the windiest places in the state.
The extreme environments of North Carolina's high elevation peaks play host to an ancient and rare ecosystem, the spruce-fir forest.
We are sitting in a spruce-fir forest near the top of Grandfather Mountain. This ecosystem is so important for providing habitat for several species of plants and animals that really are unique to this area. Red spruce, Fraser fir, galax, a variety of mosses and lichens, Heller's blazing star, and Roan Mountain bluet. These species are adapted to survive in these harsh conditions. They grow very slowly. They don't disperse very far. They're really limited to these mountain peaks, which we can think of as almost like islands in the sky. In order to survive over time, really, they just hunker down. Their strategy is to persist.
So this is a small Fraser fir, and this is a good example of a small sapling that could be 40 to 50 years old that's in the understory here, just waiting for its opportunity to get sunlight and grow to the canopy.
When we're walking through old growth forests, we often think about the trees as being old, but many people don't think about the herbs. This patch of galax took decades to establish. It's another reason we need to protect these natural areas and to think about how we can connect them to a resilient landscape.
Because of the 2,000-foot elevation change from its base to the peak, hiking from the bottom to the top of Grandfather Mountain can be compared ecologically with walking from Georgia all the way to Canada, which is what allows the area to support a huge diversity of species.
Grandfather Mountain is an international biosphere reserve. There's over 400 biospheres globally, and they identify the most unique places on the planet. Here at Grandfather, we have more than 70 listed rare and endangered plants and animals that call this place home. Many of those are endemic, meaning they're only found in two or three places on the planet.
But because they're so specially adapted, these species are threatened by shifts in temperature and precipitation caused by our changing climate.
We don't know how the species are going to be able to adapt over time. Historically, the Earth has warmed and cooled periodically, but the changes that we're seeing today may be happening faster than they happened in the past.
One of the things that's been interesting the last few years have been really heavy rainfalls in the spring, especially in May. The net, when you look at the annual precip, it's about the same as it's been in the past, but the way that that occurs is quite different. We've had two really epic 300-year flood events that have happened in back-to-back years in May. And of course, that's followed by droughts.
Warmer temperatures also mean that faster-growing species from further down the mountain could creep upwards and outcompete the slower-growing species at the top, like the red spruce and Fraser firs.
Here in North Carolina, there's been a lot of research looking at projections and estimations of how much temperature increase could cause retreat. We believe about 3 degrees would cause a 1,000-foot retreat of spruce fir forest. So 3-degree annual temperature could potentially take spruce fir forest off the top of Grandfather Mountain with time.
It's so important for us to recognize these places as unique for North Carolina and to protect them now, because if we lose them, we're not going to get them back.
Land conservation efforts are a critical tool for reducing human impact and keeping these unique places around for the future. Organizations like the Natural Heritage Program and the North Carolina Land and Water Fund work together with local governments and land trusts to establish a resilient network of nature preserves across the state.
So when we conserve a piece of land, we preserve and protect that land forever. Grandfather Mountain is remarkable ecologically in its own right. And fortunately, it's permanently protected, the entire mountain. But it actually extends well down the valley. For example, Wilson Creek has its source on the highest point of Grandfather Mountain and falls 4,000 feet vertically down into what is some of the best trout water in the southeastern United States. This landscape scale conservation, like Grandfather Mountain and the areas below it in the valley, are so important because it gives plants and animals a migration corridor during this time of intense stress with climate change.
And beyond protecting our prized natural areas like Grandfather Mountain, land conservation can actually play a critical role in mitigating the effects of climate change.
North Carolina has been protecting land for many, many years, and we've long recognized the value of land conservation for protecting wildlife habitat, for protecting these unique ecosystems. What we've learned more recently is that land conservation also helps reduce the effects of climate change by pulling carbon dioxide out of our atmosphere and storing carbon in our trees and our soils and below ground.
When you think about climate change and you think about the things that are happening in our world, there's some optimism there that we at least have protected the place so that we can allow those changes to play out.
Thanks, y'all, for watching this video. And if you want more where that came from, check out our channel, Sci and See. Stick around.